The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests and the scribes, and be killed and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan, you are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with the angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This past week, I was thinking about the number of digital devices that each of us have in our possession that help us stay in touch. Things like an iPhone or an iPad, things like an Apple Watch, things like a PlayStation or a gaming console, or even a smart TV. We use those items to stay in touch with the world around us, and they have the ability to bring everything in the universe almost right into our living rooms, right near us, so that we can see and participate in them. But of course, one of the dangerous things about technology is that it advances so quickly that what was top drawer yesterday is no longer even considered very effective today. And because it changes so quickly, we're left wondering, what are the good and bad uses? What are the moral and ethical uses of this technology that we've been given? Regularly, we get on that technology and we access sites like Google, search engines like Google, and we ask questions about what we want to know or what troubles us, and Google gives us hundreds of sites that we can consult. Of course, the problem is we don't know what some of those sites contain, whether they contain good answers or true answers, or whether they are outdated answers or just plain false answers. You know, you can get on your Google search engine and type in anything you want on that information bar. Let's say you want to research hang gliding. You type that in and press the search button, and almost in 1 or 2 seconds, you have a whole list of sites that'll tell you everything from what hang gliding is to where the best sites are in the United States to hang glide, to how you can build your own hang glider. But that same technology can be utilized by pressing the same search button and accessing hundreds of thousands of pornographic sites, things that contain evil things that corrupt our hearts and souls and lead us away from the Lord. We can even get on our devices and contact places like Hy-Vee and give them our grocery list, and within a very short time, those groceries are delivered to our doors. But that same technology can link us to sites that are gaming and gambling sites that cause us to be parted from our money quickly. And that money goes to places where it should not go. That technology can both be an aid and an addiction. I got on to Google this past week to do some research, and I found out some interesting facts. And I think these are fairly trustworthy facts because they came from the federal government. Right now, the people of the United States are in a love affair with social media. Nearly 68% of us have a social profile on one of those media, and nearly three quarters of that number say that they access that site daily, sometimes multiple times during the day. And when asked why they do it, they say they do it to stay in touch. There are statistics that would suggest that many Americans, in fact, maybe most Americans, are on as many as 8 social media platforms. Things like Instagram and YouTube and LinkedIn or Linked Down or Linked Up. Things like Facebook and things that lead us to stay in touch with other people. WeChat and the like. And one of the most insidious of all of them is Snapchat, which allows you to send a message to someone, and once you access it, it disappears. There's some statistics out that suggest that most Americans today stay on their iPhones or their Droids or their personal devices as much as 2 hours and 55 minutes per day. They're not always accessing social media. Maybe they're making phone calls or checking the internet or doing some job-related type of thing, but they're on those devices nearly 3 hours a day, and statistics would suggest that by 2021, that will have increased 9 minutes and pushed us over the top into the three-hour range. To keep that in perspective, we spend more time on our devices than we do cooking our food, cleaning our houses, and sometimes caring for the people that God has charged us to take care of, and that we are bound by Him to look after. Well, today I think we are asked to look at two things from Scripture. I suggest that, really three things, I suggest that you reread the second reading today from St. Paul that talks about be not conformed to the present age. Use what God gives us in the right way. But I also call you to remember what you read in the book of Exodus when you read the Decalogue, the Ten Commandments, the first commandment which says, I am the Lord your God. You will not have false gods before me. And certainly I think many of us treat our devices with a greater sense of familiarity and interest than we treat our relationship with the one true God. Our iPhones and our iPads, all of that can become a false god that keeps us away from the God that will lead and guide and save us. I am the Lord your God. You shall not have false gods before me. And secondly, we're called to look at that line in the gospel today from St. Matthew, which says, "What profit you if you gain the whole world, but in the process suffer the loss of your life, suffer the loss of your soul?" And certainly we can misuse that technology and seemingly gain the whole world, seemingly stay in touch with everyone around us, and in the process ignore those things that are most important for our salvation and suffer the loss of our souls at the end of our lives. So today we are called to look at how we use the gifts that we have been, that have been placed in our hands by our own hard work and invention. Are we using them in a moral way, or are we using them in a way that corrupts and harms us? I'm not at all suggesting that we should get rid of our devices. Devices are neutral. An iPhone is neutral. The sin lies within us on how we use them. So today, as St. Paul says, be not conformed to the present age, but pay attention to what is most needful for our relationship with God and our eternal salvation. May the peace of the Lord be with you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.